I guess I'm in a pretty good mood and had a pretty good skate session, so I'm going to talk about shit. I had some fun last night, basically, and hung out. And ran into two girls that were just bitchy. Like, well, at first it was like, okay, I'm just, I wanted to wear sunglasses last night just because that's how I felt like I was going to do that night. So kiss my ass. And like, I knew somebody was going to have to try to pull my card and try, you know, flex on me and try to give me shit for it, which is fine. I grew up in blue collar. That's how we were raised. You know, you weren't friends with anybody unless they were giving you shit about who you were or some mistake you made when you were a little kid or something. And so I was prepared for it because I'm trying to look cool and have fun tonight. You know what I mean? I guess I'm a rock star. I mean, this sounds ridiculous, but it's true. And like, so, somebody's girl wants to run the goddamn mouth to me for 20 minutes. And at first, you know, I'm like defending myself every fucking step I can, as polite and funny as I can. But then this girl tried to keep clowning on me, try to call me Goofy Movie, which is funny because she didn't know that I have a fucking music video out where I'm wearing a Goofy hat from fucking Disney. I went to Disneyland during COVID. And I'm wearing all these cartoon character fucking things, like, on my... And so, because I'm saying I'm a cartoon character. I'm a cartoon character to get up here and dance in front of a camera like this. So, this is all this weaving and intricate nonsense. She doesn't even know I made this video, right? So, she keeps calling me, like, I look off some dude from the Goofy movie or something. I'm like, okay, that's nice. You know what I mean? But she couldn't let go of it. And then she's trying to, like, put it in my face, like, she was making fun of me. And I was like, dude, I don't give a fuck what you think. And, like, I literally had to tell her that. And it was, like, it got to a point where I had to be disrespectful to her. And she was actually asking for it. And it was, like, weird. And it was, like, some weird public, damn near S&M bullshit. It's, like, I've had this happen to me before. Like, girls don't like it when you got so much goddamn confidence. They want to fuck with you because they're bored. And they want to see how strong you really are. And I think it's, I don't know, I don't want to get too much into it. But it was annoying. And the bitch wouldn't give up. Motherfucker, neither would I. Because I wasn't fucking flexing, bitch. I was telling the truth on every step I took, everything I did. And it was funny because she had a little friend that tried to gang up too. But really, I went all the way down to town on the motherfucker. And then once I really got real saucy and said some fucking shit, then they broke down and were trying to be my goddamn best friend. It was ridiculous. Some girl opened up to me about how her family isn't there for and shit. And really, you know, it was like, yeah, me neither. But I don't even know if I said that. You know what I mean? I was just listening to her for feelings and whatnot, because apparently she can't tell her husband, sitting right now goddamn next to her, fucking sitting here talking to me like that with her fucking boyfriend, sitting right there. The whole thing was a goddamn mess. Really, I was trying to wingman for my friends because it was a special time for him, so I'm gonna make sure he had a special time for him. Like, so I was trying to wingman for him and shit. I'm not even in the game for that kind of stuff. I'm fucking taken, you know what I mean? And there ain't nothing more macho than staying faithful to your girl for real. And so plus I'm not even into these bitches, like, but it was weird. I had to keep fucking scooting off and talking to other people. Had some random ass girl all over me taking my glasses and doing photo shoots and shit. It was ridiculous. And I was very polite to her, you know what I mean? Oh, you're very polite, nice. And then at the end of it, I took my glasses away from her, walked off. And then they all left, thank God. And then at a certain point, it was time for me to leave. But I showed myself out without, so I didn't get in anybody's way. Because it was like, literally, every time someone tried to challenge me that night, not only did I stand up for myself, but I ended up becoming the center of attention. And then everybody was like in awe of me. And it was like, what are you in awe of? Like, it's kind of weird, like, so many people are afraid to be themselves in public, and whenever someone actually does, it is like some goddamn thing that it shouldn't be. And this is why I kept trying to tell this person. She thought she could, like, socially insecure me, and it was like, you can't. And I don't think she understood that, because maybe she's never met anybody like us. And I say us because there's a lot of people like me out there. And bitch, that shit, and literally, she's looking for that same self-confidence, to be honest. But it's like, I'm not your husband, and I ain't here to give it to you.